Yo, yo, yo. So welcome to another episode of Vic Cook, and today we're making spaghetti and meat sauce with catfish. So I get all my meats and my seasonings, pastas and sauces and veggies together. And then, so what I do is I throw a little bit of garlic in the cast iron with my Italian sausage and my ground beef. And I'm going to let that cook while I prep other things. And then also add a little bit of thyme on top, because why not? So then I get my catfish steaks. And then I'm going to put that in the bag of some fish fry mix, or you can use breadcrumbs, whatever you want, and just give that a good shake, mix it all around really good. So then next you're going to get your onions, like I got here, and then I pretty much just cut the onions up, dice it up as small or as big as you can, but I want it to mix in a sauce, so I want them small, a little bit, a little chunky, but not too chunky, you know, it's like you don't want them too thin where they kind of just run all over the place. And then also get my green bell pepper. That adds like a decent amount of flavor to it. So I just cut those. I cut them in like small little strips at first. And then I kind of cut them up as small as I can, because these can be a little bit, they're a little bit more crunchier. So I like to keep them like that. So then I go back to my skillet. I'm flipping over my sausages. And then at this point, I'm going to add in my veggies. So I got my onions and bell peppers in there. And that's just all going to cook together with the meat sauce and add a nice little flavor. I'm adding some olive oil to it as well. And then also I got my pot burning to boil my pasta. And I also got the pot in the back to fry my fish. So when the meat is pretty much about seared on both sides, I'm just going to go ahead and just cut it open. That way it'll be easier to mix as it cooks. And then also all those meat juices is going to get all over the pan, and then also the veggies are going to mix in there. It's going to be a nice little mix. So I got some purple salt that I added in there as well for my pasta to lower the boiling temperature of it. So then now I get all my seasonings together, and it's just your onion powder, garlic powder. I got some crushed red pepper, and I got some peppercorn mix that I'm using, a little bit of parsley, you could add some oregano, and I also got some Cabernet red wine. So now I'm mixing everything together. My meat's mostly cooked. There's a few bites here and there that are undercooked, but that'll all cook down eventually. So now I'm just adding all my seasonings, a little bit of crushed red pepper flakes if you want a little bit of spice to it. Now, from what I hear, a lot of people can use like carrots or carrot juice to kind of bring down the acidity of the tomato juice, but that's why I got the wine for. You'll see that later. So I just give my pasta a stir, and now I'm just making sure all my meat and veggies are all nice and mixed up together. They're simmering nice, and the kitchen's smelling great right about now. I haven't used all my bowl of seasonings, but so what I do is I just transfer everything into a wok, because it'll be easier to make my sauce. If you see my macaroni and cheese video, I like to do everything in the wok. So now I got my red sauce in there, and I'm adding some more seasonings, and now it's bam, it's pretty much ready like it is, but of course we're gonna work with a little bit more. Just letting it simmer, let everything kind of soften up and sit together. Of course, taste of preference. I'm adding the, I figured I'd add the rest of my seasoning, because why not? And it went from a bright red to like a darker red, because I added some wine in there, and that kind of lets me know how much wine to add. You don't want to add too much, because it can be overpowering, but just enough to kind of darken a little bit, and then you'll be good to go. And also, it adds a little bit of flavor. It does take out that acidity-ness. And then, of course, take a couple sips for good measure. So my pasta's about done, my meat sauce is looking nice and delicious. So the next step, pretty much just let everything simmer. You can stir and play around with it as you want to. So the next thing I'm going to do is, while that's sitting, I'm going to get my grease hot to get ready to fry my fish. And then now for my meal prep, I'm just going to divvy up the pasta as I see fit. And, of course, a bowl for me for right now. And then the extras, I put in a little extra bowl over there. You know, you always got extras when you meal prep sometimes. So now I'm just putting in my meat sauce, just pounding it right on top of there. And it's good to go. And I will say these are delicious at work. Very easy to heat up. But the meat sauce kind of just heated up and ran down into the pasta, so it was all mixed. And I make sure I use every bit of meat sauce. Nothing goes to waste. And then I cover up everything just to kind of keep... I don't know why I covered it up. I did. I covered it up. I should have just left it uncovered, because I did. At this point, I forgot that I got to add the catfish steaks in there. I should have added them in there earlier, but I was overwhelmed, I guess you could say. Had a lot going on in the kitchen. So I pretty much just, you pretty much just throw them in the fryer and then let them do its thing. And then when they're done, They'll be done. Then I just throw them on the other side of it. And you can make garlic bread if you want to, but I chose not to have garlic bread this time. I didn't want my meal to be too starchy. And yeah, the catfish takes a little minute to cook, but once you get it up there, once it's golden brown and once they start floating in there, you'll see those nice golden brown crispy pieces, and then you just take them out. And yeah, so definitely meal prepping has helped me a lot. Definitely saving money when I'm at work, but it's also also very convenient. Whereas I don't have to cook as often. I can just cook something that I made yesterday or whatever. So then I just separate my fish, and I got some more fish that I'm frying up too. But as of now, I'm ready to eat. So then for my meal prep, I just package up everything. And thanks for tuning in. Like, comment, subscribe.